actually, surprisingly, considering the fact that the Wirral has had the same recycling service for the past 12 years, it is still very confusing to a lot of residents. And actually, some of the feedback that we're getting about the additional bin, through the additional bin audit, is that some residents think that they can only recycle cardboard. Some residents don't realise that it's not just plastic milk jugs that they can, it's all plastic bottles. It is something that we're constantly looking at and trying to change our messages and working with RAP to try and make sure that our messages are the same as everybody else's. But more recently, the MRWA has actually produced a new communications package called Recycle Right. And it's Recycle Right for Merseyside because, as you say, many other councils collect different materials to us in different ways to us. I mean, even in Merseyside, we all collect our recycling in a different coloured bin. So even though we all collect the same materials, apart from St. Helens, it's in a different coloured bin. So Recycle Right is what is recyclable in Merseyside. And it's a very user-friendly website that they've produced. And the whole comms package, and it actually goes through for each material, can it be recycled, where can it be recycled, and if not, why not? So they only launched that in July, I believe. So we've signed up to that, and we will be using that as part of our targeted communications, really trying to see what is the best method to engage with residents. Having face-to-face conversations is obviously the best way of doing it, but that only hits a very small percentage. So it was just we're constantly looking at how to improve our communications, how to help that confusion, so that residents know what they can actually put in their room recycling bin.
Thank you very much. Christina.
Again, thank you very much. That was very interesting. I can't agree with Tony when he says the 12 containers are bad. I can't agree. In Anglesey, where I am a lot of the time, if I could be, I'd be there all the time. I think everything virtually is recycled. So, in effect, one of those very narrow bins that I was 3/4 full after 3 weeks with at least 20 people going through the house all around. Because everything else was recycled. And in our house, everything that we can't recycle on Wirral, we take to places where you can recycle. And I know it sounds sad, but we just don't like the fact that we are putting recyclable materials into our bins. So as much as possible, we try and take it to other places. What I'd like to know is there any way that the other people, the other areas where they recycle more, they deal with different system, right? Is there any way we could sell that waste to them? so we'd have two contracts rather than one. I can see what you say that they can't change what they collect, but that doesn't mean to say that we can't collect it and put it, give it to somebody else. And I just wondered if that's too costly to do.
I think that's a question that could be asked of the MRWA. Say at the moment, all of our waste is consigned to them. So if we were going to change that, it would be a potential contract variation. So I would say that's potentially something that could be answered then. The only thing that I would say is that depending on materials, those other councils might not actually be recycling it at the moment. They might be stockpiling it or storing it because they don't have the end reprocessors to take it.
I've asked councillors in those areas to find out that for me, because that's something that we've wondered about.
Finally, Anita.
Thanks, Chair. I had a similar question to Christina, and I was just wondering whether we could use like the bring backs for those things that we can't recycle. The other thing, Tony, you mentioned about the flats earlier. One of the things that we are doing as a council is that when we have new planning applications, we're actually now bringing in the recycling aspect of that into bin storage. So that's one element where we are. But you know, in terms of the apartments, it's really, really difficult with some of them, because you know, we've got some that have got chutes, and you know, you can't recycle them, etc. And I'll take exactly what you say about contaminating the bins as well. But there are plenty of bin storage places in the Wirral for apartments that don't have recycling facilities. And you know, I think we should look at the cost of putting recycling bins into those areas so that we can get some recycling done. Another thing is, you know, the government targets about what we should be recycling. My question is, what are the government doing about stopping unnecessary packaging and in terms of organisations using packaging which can't be recycled? So I'd be interested to know if you've got an answer to that. And finally, well, no, we've got two other points, sorry. Just in terms of cat litter, which obviously when it's contaminated it's very heavy, is there something that we can do if you know people have got a number of cats? Is there something they can do separately in terms of cat litter? Because I know that is very heavy and fills the bins quite quickly. And also, I'd be interested in knowing who are 10% of those reforming areas are. And certainly, you know, as a rural councillor, it's one of my areas. Those 10%, then I'd like to do something with the housing associations and the development trust in my area. Thanks.
We have, because I think that list was actually distributed after the last attractive local environment members group, which groups, which rounds it was.
Could you just ask if that distributed to all councillors?
No, I think it just went to those.
I think it'd be useful for it to go out to all councils, because all councils would, you know, if they've got the information, we can then do something about it.
Yeah, no, that's fine. I'm happy to do that. We've got the map that goes with it as well, not just the road, so that's fine. Just trying to remember this. So the cat litter, I actually had that issue and I changed my cat litter. One that that wasn't as heavy and I didn't need to use as much of. I'm sorry, could you just remind me what your first question was?
Yeah, well, just in terms of the cat litter, I think what you'll find is it's down to cost with people. So if they can get a bag of cat litter for £1.50, they've got to pay £6.50, and then each one they're likely to choose. But, you know, again, there could be some sort of incentive. The other one was regarding the apartments that don't have smaller facilities and what the government are doing.
About packaging,
and non-recycled packaging with the company.
That is one of the things that we are anticipating will be part of the new resources and waste strategy. The packaging recovery notes, the producer responsibility, the idea is that it puts more responsibility on the producers of that packaging to help encourage its collection and its recycling and its reuse at the end. So whether that is the looking into the deposit return scheme for single-use plastics, just plastic bottles. I know there's quite a lot of press around the really bad packaging, such as Pringles and bottles, the things that are mixed materials. Anything that's bad press for the companies, they will probably have been straight on it and trying to see how they could improve their packaging. The government has also they've also put quite a lot of money into research into new packaging. And I think actually, if I remember correctly, it's a global fund that is available for new types of packaging that are for better for the circular economy. packaging, which the MRWA are involved with, Unilever are involved with, and it's looking at how they can. So there is work that is going on. I think as well one of the things that is being looked at is the information on the packaging, to try and dispel any confusion that if something's got a recycled symbol on it, many residents think that because it's recycled can go in the recycle bin. That's not always the case, so it's trying to help residents by not putting those kind of messages on the plastic.
Thank you, Claire. Are we all happy to agree recycling task and finish, or commit a recycling task and finish to our work programme?
Yes.
I was going to say volunteer on the back of the postage.
I think
what we'll do is send out an email asking for volunteers rather than put folks on the spot now.
I'm quite happy to volunteer now.
Okay, thanks, Christina. Adam, okay, thank you. We've got two volunteers, one more, or two more. We send the email out as well. Well, thanks to those who have volunteered.
Okay.
And thank you, Alan.
Chair, could I ask, as we sort of work in head for yourself, concentric on that group, is there any chance that we don't have to meet in Wallasey in our room?
I think if you're going to have a task and finish group, you can host it whenever you see fit.
It's the cost of the rooms, because there's some strange rule which says you don't have to pay for the room if it's here, but you have to pay for the room if you say went to Birkenhead Town Hall or any other building owned by a Wirral or a council. I don't know why.
If we get out before 9 o'clock, you can have it in your front.
No, I don't want to see my room, thank you.
Perhaps that would be the first thing the task and finish group look at, then would be the venues,
yeah,
and the rotation of venues and things like that.
Yeah.
I don't think that's unreasonable that you set your own terms of reference in terms of how often, how long, when, you know, that type of thing.
So, yeah.
Well, I will ask Mike to send out an email as well, just to see if we can perhaps get another member to take part. Thank you very much for that, folks. That brings us to item 9, which is a quarter of one Wirral plan performance, pages 67-84 of your paperwork. And I'll start by inviting Mark to present the report, please. Thank you.
Thank you, Chair. So this is the performance report in the usual format. As you said, it's from the first quarter to the end of June. That usual format is that there's an appendix with for every single one of the pledges in the Wirral plan, an overview of progress, and then the headline indicators and supporting measures. So obviously sat behind this and on the council website is progress on all of the detailed actions and the work that sits below. Obviously this is just the summary.
Keep your hand up just for a moment, please. Okay, sorry, Liz.
I've got a question for
microphone.
I have a question about smoking and weight reduction programs and services being offered. We've got the figures are for smoking reduction. We've got market, the areas of the greatest need. So we are saying, yes, you can do that contract, but you can be our service provider, but it must be borough-wide, and it must be targeted at the areas where people need it most.
Okay, thank you, Chair. I think the best course of action there would be I'll ask my colleague down to public health to come back with a detailed response on those issues in the full set.
Very happy with that, Chair. Steve, you were next.
Yes, a couple of points. First one was about the crime figures, and you believe the reduction in antisocial behaviour is to be welcomed. Now, when you look at the sort of actions, one particularly on the board of crime and prison board, if those two actions in those two areas reduced it by 21%, then that must have been, oh, Christ. I'll start again. Go back to the issue around crime. 21% reduced in ASB, which is to be welcomed. But the actions that are marked are around a couple, two or three areas. Now, unless those areas were so bad that that's contributing 21%. So I just wonder, you know, to have a 21% reduction is very significant. But the things that we are providing to the council, such as diversion activity, the hive, and so on and so forth, are making a genuine contribution, or is it just down to these particular areas where there must be such bad hotspots if you go in there? And it goes down. And it leads me on to then the increase in crime. And it's difficult for lay members to know what is a real crime and what's actually social behaviour. But nowhere in the literature do we actually point the finger that there's not as many police around. I mean, that's, you know, if we're not honest with ourselves, people will commit crime if they don't think they'll get calls. And my view is that it's a blame then, and perhaps it's officers not being allowed to be political, but there's less police, then crime goes up. And just maybe for a future meeting, what those sort of crimes are. I know violent crimes on the increase, because that's highlighted in the report. So just clarification around that. And the other one, some sort of contradictory stuff going on.
Yeah.
The other thing I would like to see at the time, it's FBN. FBN's going down in number, means behavioural change, but we're saying it's a rare strength. I think that should be a better trend. If they're going down, is that what we're trying to aim at? If it's less, and we're still got the same activity, it means less people are dropping into. So perhaps I can think about that. And the final one is some contradiction around, we talk about the number of increased non-nurse subscribers on page 82, yes, as being better, so 814 more than then. There's a contradiction in the where we criticise the second column down, and it says garden waste composting that fell slightly this year due to the decrease in number of subscribers following the removal of the online discount for subscriptions. So one is saying we're improving the numbers, and the other saying the reason for poor performance is less numbers. So we just maybe not do it tonight, but we'll try to find out those discrepancies. Thank you.
Thanks, Steve. Adam?
Thanks, Chair. Just a quick comment. On the way into my introduction on the radio about how well crossing London smoking levels are dropping, I'm just wondering why the Northwest obviously is higher than England, why we aren't seeing that same trend as the drop of smoking, especially now vaping has become popular, whether that seems a good thing or not. It's certainly reducing people to smoking cigarettes as well. Sort of more traditional things. And then just pick up the point, I think I've made this before, you know, a few times, the FBN notice isn't a good measure. Because like Steve says, it's because people are dropping litter or because we're not catching as many people. So both ways measures it. So we do need to come up with something different that actually gets to whether people are perceiving less litter, which is or less dog around, that's what we're really trying to achieve.
Yeah, I mean, I'll just respond to a few of them. So around the we obviously had the lengthy debate at the calling meeting, at the King contract calling meeting. So I think we obviously need to be tracking FPNs in terms of our enforcement activity. But then we're right over a period of time, and as we've seen in other areas such as parking enforcement, ideally, ultimately, if we get a behaviour change, if at some point in the future we're going to see that enforcement activity is going to drop off because we are delivering our outcomes. I guess it's looking at the broader measures that we've got and the absolute measures around the environment is obviously linking back to our local environmental quality, which is actually performing very well. So it's looking at some of those together. Just on the crime reporting side of things. So from some of the discussions that have taken place around the safety community partnership table, certainly it's been highlighted that recently the measure of crime has changed. And one of the debates I recall that I think we touched on here is that now in that measure, in that crime measure, it's including, for example, things like offences on social media and the internet. So they're actually being classed as crime. And certainly the local chief inspector is actually saying that those kind of instances are having an impact on the field. So to what extent it's that, to what extent it's less police resources, we haven't quite got that far, but that's certainly certainly a factor there. So Paul, thanks on both of those, Chair.
Okay, Allan. Thank you, Chair. Just a very quick question on page 79 in the paper version, about reducing homelessness. Just two questions, really. What do those figures actually represent for year-end 2017-18, 998? What is that actually a measure of? What is it referring to? And it would be helpful, you know, actually what the homelessness figures themselves are across the world. To know what we're actually reducing.
I'll provide a note on that.
Thank you. Tell me.
Yeah, I mean, actually, it's just following on from what Allan and homelessness. I mean, it was good to see the new homeless reduction act come into play and that, and the extra money that was given under the government of New Burden. But what really worries me is that there's the same. That due to the new Act, trend comparison with previous year's data has now been removed. I mean, you'd want to know, wouldn't you, over the last number of years, it's meaningless, isn't it? If they're saying then we've only got 900 this year, well, what did we have last year, 400 or 200? It seems an awful thing to do, really, to remove the trend comparisons and that. Why would the government do that?
I won't leave the time to answer that.
Just go back on that. I mean, could someone check it out? Whoever is actually involved in the homelessness part of the authority and knows a little bit about the Act and perhaps give a little commentary on what you feel about that particular aspect of it.
I think your question's very fair and very reasonable. And I think we'll give Mark the task of finding out and actually coming up with some figures that are meaningful as opposed to meaningless. Would you be happy with that?
Yes, that's fine.
Okay. Do we have any more questions on this particular item? Anita?
Thanks, Chair. It's page 81 of the paper pack, and the violence that caused injury to an individual victim not included homicide. Just a question regarding the domestic related crime. Is that, what does that actually mean? Is that domestic abuse or is that
breaking the house? I'm not even sure what it means. I think that's the domestic abuse measure, I think.
So if you read it all, I don't think it can be more. Read it again.
Sure. It used to be called domestic abuse separately, I'm sure.
It
non-violent crime. So that's why when we talk then about domestic related crime, it sort of like threw me a little bit.
Chair, is there any support the new way of reporting the police have got? I think we'd have to get verification from the police on this one. I know we've changed.
I'll check up on that, whether it's, I'm just looking at now whether it's, you know, the domestic abuse coming through the mouth or not, so I'll just, I'll get some clarification on that, and we'll come back on that.
I think if it was showing that, you know, it's like there was more reporting of domestic violence, you know, given that one of our pledges is encouraging reporting of domestic abuse over the last 2 years and done a lot of work on that, I would expect that we would have more reports. But it just doesn't read like this health sentence doesn't read like the results of our research. Thank you.
I think in terms of clarifying it, if we are in a position where it's part of our performance plan, we're actually monitoring it. I think it's beholden on us from the scrutiny committee. If someone changes the method of reporting or moves the goalposts, I don't think it's unreasonable that they at least tell us that they've done that. So I think that really needs to be considered. If they are going to change the reporting mechanisms and the way they do it, they have to be notified that they've done that. Yes, Christina.
Yeah, I'm sure that at the constituency committees when we had our report, certainly in Wirral South, we were told about the changing of reporting, and that's why the figures were different that month. So I'm sure we have had it reported to us. And I declare you just have several some who's in the police, but he hasn't told me anything like this. But I think it must be because it's the I'm sure that's what they said, why there was increases in various areas, which wasn't as horrific as we thought it was. Still horrific, but not as bad as we thought.
Okay, given that then, and the fact that we're presented with data to scrutinise, I think it's beholden on whoever is actually presenting that data.
Yes.
Tell us if they move the goalposts.
Yes.
I don't think that's an unreasonable request. Any more questions on that particular item? No, thank you. Can we agree the recommendation with those caveats then? Is everyone happy? Yeah. Thank you. That brings us on to item 10 then. Agenda item 10. You all have a copy of the paperwork in front of you.
Yeah.
On behalf of the committee to agree the work programme with the addition of the recycling EIN to the Okay, thank you very much. That takes us to item 11. I have had no notice of any other business, so I would formally call the meeting to a close. Thank you all very much for your contribution and your attendance. Thank you.